Take your positions, please, as we drop downhill through turn 13 and then the final corner 14. We'll begin the final lap of the race. Can Sergio Garcia there in fifth do anything about this fight out ahead? It's now time to get into the slipstream. We start the final lap of the race here in Barcelona.
It looks like it's one of these front four, doesn't it? Foggia hugs the outside of the circuit, trying to break the slipstream. His Honda is a rocket. He's called the Rocket. And is he rocketing towards a second victory here in 2020?
Foggia did well there to lead onto the home straight and stay there, but he defended into turn one, and that's allowed Darren Binder to come through. And we know Binder is so strong into turn four. That's what he'll be looking for now.
He's had brilliant edge grip through turn three, and then he's able to get the exit speed as well. Is he going to be close enough to strike on Foggia? He is. Is he going to look at it? No, he's not close enough. That's brilliant by Foggia. You can't rule out Garcia, who's come back into this contention as well. They sweep through turn four for the last time. Is Binder going to look at him up the inside of turn five?
Well, you just got to believe he is, and he does. And can he hold it? That's a brilliant move from Darren Binder. And he's nudged Foggia wide. That's allowed Arbolino through. Great move from the South African. Remember, Darren Binder never won a Grand Prix.
Yeah, the Binder brothers, they know what it's like to win in Moto3. Brad Binder won 2016 in Valencia, the last time a South African won in a lightweight world championship. There's never been a better chance for a younger brother, Darren, now to repeat those heroics.
Tony Arbolino, though, he's got such great speed, hasn't he, now, as he looks to go into the slipstream. Will he leave it late to break into turn 10? Darren Binder, though, leaves it even later. The fans in South Africa are on their feet at the moment.
Well, they really are. Brad Binder, we're watching in his motorhome. He'll have no nails left going into MotoGP race then. Arbolino, no way through. There's just a couple of corners left now for Binder to defend. Over the crest, he'll come dropping down the hill into the fast right-hander. Darren Binder still leading this Barcelona battle as the end of the left for Arbolino.
It's now or never for Arbolino. Darren Binder, surely it's his to lose. As they come around the final corner, the chequered flag is out.
Done it.
He's finally done it. Dive bomb, Binder, blast it in Barcelona. He finally wins his first ever race in Moto3. And it's a long time coming. Huge 20 points for Arbolino. Foggia's on the podium in third as well. What a win for Darren Binder.
Oh, what a way to respond after the crushing disappointment of those crashes when battling for the lead in Misano 1 and Misano 2. Absolutely awesome ride by Binder. Absolutely stunning last lap. Brilliant move on Foggia at turn 5. That was the key move of the race. Second goes to Tony Arbolino, the pole man. Great ride by Foggia. He takes third. Good boost for him after that Brno win. And Ayagura came over the line in 11th place. They were crucial world championship points gained late on by the Japanese man.
Absolutely delighted for Darren Binder. He has threatened this for so many years. And even in the last couple of weeks, he's been in contention and has thrown it down the road. But that was a mature ride from Darren Binder. It really was. It's absolutely excellent for him. There will not be too many people in the paddock upset to see that young man get up onto the top step. And you know what? He has followed his brother Brad so often around the world, desperately wanting to be the one that stands on the top step hearing the South African national anthem. Well, now it is your moment. What a win.
Yeah, grabbing a few headlines himself after brother Brad's heroics so far this year. He is just the second South African rider to win a lightweight world championship race, and it's all come from the same household, the Binders. That's the eighth win for the Binder family. Tony Arbolino, good ride in second place. That's going to ignite some momentum into his championship challenge. And Foggia, he was leading, wasn't he, on that last lap, and then Binder squeezed through at turn five, and that move by Binder just ran Foggia out wide. That allowed Arbolino through, and Foggia couldn't find a way back. Sergio Garcia, credit to him, fourth, easily his best result of the season so far. Likewise, Alonso Lopez in fifth. 6 second penalty coming the way of Jeremy Alcoba, failing to comply with the long lap penalty, which means that he's going to be well outside the points, because he'd done one long lap penalty.